It is Cross Country Weekly Update time. Rod DeHaven warming up with the knuckleball in the bullpen, but our starting pitcher is Alex Muntefering. We're going to talk women's cross country, then men's. To open the year, it's always one of those situations where you just kind of want to see where things are at, right? And so week one, what did you see down in Vermilion?
Yeah, it was ultimately a reconnaissance trip for us, so we opened up a very small group of women. Six competed for us. Of course, we have a much larger squad, but we were able to take the entire squad down there and just preview the course. You know, from a competitive standpoint, we went against most of USD's full squad, and so I challenged some of the ladies just to break up their pack a little bit. From a course preview standpoint, the course looks to be in pretty good shape, so we were happy to see that. We're excited to be on there later this season.
Following up with that, again, that's where the Summit League Championships will be. That's why that's so important. What are the advantages to getting out on the course in the weeks ahead of the Summit League Champion?
It just helps to clear up any uncertainties about, is the footing going to be good? Are the turns going to be sharp and tight? How many hills or bumps in the courses will there be? So, you know, just to clear any of those questions so that's not inducing undesirable stress, and clearing up those unknowns, it just helps to give us some level of comfort that, you know, we can rely on later in the season.
In the case of Friday, were you looking at times at all? Are you looking at, hey, if somebody gets put in a spot, how they react to it? What were you looking for from the student athletes on Friday?
Yeah, the way I like to do things early on the season is give a little less direction, allow the student athletes to have some more creative power in this, and then we'll make adjustments. And so I've challenged the ladies, don't be afraid to go out, test some things, make some mistakes, that's fine, and we'll make adjustments as we need to.
You mentioned the fact that not nearly the whole roster was entered in this event. Now you have the Augustana Twilight coming up. Will you have more entered this weekend?
Yeah, you'll see really the full squad competing at Augustana, which is exciting for us because we're really pleased with where the program's at right now. And the Augustana Twilight, just from an atmosphere standpoint, they put out a great product for cross country. And so the fans are really into it. The high school students stick around and watch the college races. And the student athletes themselves, they really look forward to this race.
I wanted to hit on that, too, because this is so unique. How many times you're running at 10, 10:30, 11 o'clock in the morning to be doing it at night in that environment with the high school kids around, too. It's a cool little event.
It really is, yeah. So if people are in the area, like, I'd highly encourage them to come check it out. The music will be blaring very loud. It's under the lights. When you get that under the lights feeling, we see this in track more often, it gets the adrenaline flowing a lot more than those early season cross country races.
All right, and what playlist? Will you have any influence on some of the songs?
I won't. I wish I knew music as well as Rod, but unfortunately I have no influence on that.
Rod DeHaven with us, and we closed with Alex talking about the Augustana Twilight coming up and the musical selections that would be played, because that's part of the environment that you'll deal with. We'll talk about what happened last week in a moment. But since he brought that up, he said he wished that he had the musical knowledge that Rod does. So with that, I think we have to
start. It all stops roughly about like 1995. I don't really recognize too much after that.
So really, Belle Biv DeVoe is where it ceases for you?
And even there, you know, it's just, that's above me.
Well, you were a big Milli Vanilli fan.
No, I was not, but nice try.
So what's on the playlist here? What are you pushing for this weekend at Augie? What do you want to hear?
I'm not going to play any. First of all, if they could just dial up Exile on Main Street by the Rolling Stones and just let that rip, we'd be fine. But that's not going to happen, is it?
Well, you don't know that.
I, with 100% certainty, you will not hear anything from Exile on Main Street at the Augie Twilight.
I mean, let's set our standards, let's set our goals high, and let's try to achieve them. Let's not just say it's a worthless cause this early in the week.
It goes up to 11.
I will promise you we're not going to hear Stonehenge this weekend.
No, or any other.
That I feel pretty good about.
Selections from Spinal Tap either.
Which is a darn shame when you think about it.
It really is, yes.
But Nigel just had a way.
Yeah. Yep. So, yeah. So, yeah, I'm sure the kids will like the music, and I will just, you know, It'll just be background noise, much like a waterfall or something else to me. Not that I'll be meditating.
Cascading along the rocks.
Yes, along the Big Sioux.
Weaving your way through the hills and peaks and valleys of the great state of South Dakota.
Yes, we will be.
Okay, now that the Department of Tourism can send its check our way, let us discuss the opening contest of the year for your squad. Similar conversation to Alex in that you're not overly concerned about times yet. You're not competing everybody quite yet. So what did you get out of this past weekend?
Well, one, obviously exposure to the course, exposure just kind of, you know, what it'll feel like coming in the parking lot and, you know, how the setup will be. And I think, you know, the other obvious, you know, last year we had a big and talented freshman class come in, and we thought a key piece of that was Brandon Campson. And he kind of gets dinged up right when the start of school happens, so we redshirted him in the fall. And obviously had a good track year, but ended not the way, you know, we thought it would or wanted it to. And, you know, he's a very competitive individual, as, you know, most people are, you know, when you get to this point. And, you know, for him to, you know, we just talked about the pros and cons of racing. I just thought racing would be good from the standpoint of just kind of going through that exercise on grass and just kind of seeing where you're at. And then we can kind of make some decisions down the road on when we race, you know, how we train, all that kind of stuff. And just kind of remembering how to win races. And, you know, he was kind of that guy you didn't see for 4K, and then all of a sudden he's kind of near the front, and then with a K to go, he just kind of puts the gas on and, you know, really walked away pretty comfortably from the rest of the field, which, you know, it's not slouches in that field. It was some pretty quality athletes. So it was very impressive to see that, and I think, you know, hopefully pretty satisfying. I think it was fun for him because a lot of the teammates that didn't compete came down to watch, and, you know, so he performed very well. Luke Johnson, a second year from Omaha, or Elkhorn, Nebraska, I guess, to be very specific here. You also had a, you know, really, you know, good opener as well. And so I think those two young men did well. And then we had some, you know, redshirt freshmen or true freshmen run unattached who were kind of in the mix up front as well. And I think that was fun for them because typically that's not going to happen often during, you know, a cross country season, especially once you get into the kind of the mega meet competitions, you know, starting with Augie, although it's maybe a little bit different level of competition than we'll face at GRIAC and obviously pre-nationals in Wisconsin later on in October.
With only a handful running, but you took everybody down there and we had the same conversation with Alex, getting to see the course, how important is that?
Well, I think you can describe it, you know, to athletes like, well, hey, it's going to be flat. You know, there's maybe going to be a little bit harder to get away. You know, similar to our course last year, but I think this course, you know, there's enough straightaways that, yeah, if you put the jets on, you can kind of get away, or people are going to have to make decisions to commit or not. There's not going to be as many turns that are going to slow you down. And I think it's important to see that, important to have, you know, a mindset, you know, throughout the fall in terms of how we're training, you know, what we're aiming for. And you know, regardless of the year, I mean, that's the conference meets largely your big thing, particularly if you're a mid-major program. And that doesn't change, and you know, hopefully everyone that's involved with Jackrabbit men's cross country and women's cross country understands, you know, what the goal is, you know, from year to year, and you know, helping make those things happen or having a positive outcome in early November is it doesn't happen just by showing up on the day and saying, oh geez, let's put our spikes on and go for a run.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
So a full roster will compete this weekend.
Yes.
Augustana Twilight. It's such a unique, cool atmosphere. Things heating up a little bit now as we look into week two.
Well, I think just the you know, the energy with everybody racing will be, you know, kind of create a different week. And last week was so rushed and hurried with, you know, we meet for the first time officially on Monday, and hey, we're going to, you know, we take Thursday off as a non-practice day, and then, hey, we're going to race on Friday. So didn't leave you a lot of time to get a lot of things ironed out. And this week, you know, a little bit more time together, not quite as many activities going on. And yeah, there's always, you know, whether it's, this will feel more like opening day again, you know, whether it's, you know, your favorite sport, baseball or cross country, there is kind of that excitement, adrenaline that goes with that opening competition.
And we're thinking flock of seagulls on the PA?
There'll be no flock of seagulls either.
Why not? Dexie's Midnight Runners?
I could go for that, but it's not going to happen.
The Buggles? Video killed the radio star?
Nope, not going to happen.
Okay, if there's one tune you could run to, did you already hit on it, or would it be something else?
You know, one, I don't really, I jog now, so I'm not even thinking in terms of me. I don't know. I mean,
I figured it'd be The Boss, Born to Run.
Yeah. Well, that's too obvious.
No, it's not too obvious, but yeah. I'm not even sure on that album. You know, you might even go with something else on the Born to Run album.
You could.
It's a solid album.
Yeah. I mean, 10th Avenue Freeze Out's really underrated.
I mean, it's not, you know, Michael Jackson, Thriller.
No, it's not. Thank God.
Okay, we'll put the 45s away. We'll call it a day, Rod. We'll see you back here next week.
If you'll have me back, I mean.
You are welcome anytime, my friend.
At least at 9:30 on Tuesdays. Right.